A story this morning comes from NBC News. Record number of undocumented immigrants flooded the southern border in May. This is crazy. I kid you not. Because I saw this story a few days ago, and I kind of just glanced the headline, and I'm like, yeah, of course. But it's actually like 50% higher than the previous record from a month earlier. Quote, "We are in a full-blown emergency, and I cannot say this stronger. The system is broken," said acting CBP Commissioner John Sanders. Border Patrol officers encountered more than 144,000 undocumented immigrants at the southwest border in May, the largest monthly total in 13 years, officials said Wednesday. More than 132,000 were stopped while crossing the border illegally. The rest presented themselves at legal ports of entry, customs and border protection, officials said. Let me make this clear to all of you. I'm sure you get it if you watch my channel. That is the size of a small town every single month, okay? There are like, how many people live in Seattle? Like 500,000? So we're talking about every 3.5 months, Seattle coming into the United States, and we have no idea who, where, when. And keep in mind, they encountered this many. You know what that means? Let's do some basic semantic breakdown. If Border Patrol is encountering 144,000 undocumented immigrants, where do you what do you think happens for those they don't encounter? They're not in that number, which means the number is quite, in all probability, much higher in terms of the amount of illegal immigrants coming to this country. That's a serious problem. When, look, asylum seekers deserve asylum, and I believe we absolutely need to do what we can to protect those whose lives are in danger. But it's these people, okay, the illegal immigrants in this capacity, not all of them, some of them are probably legit asylum seekers, but it's a small percentage. They fill the system, they're straining it, they're breaking it, and they are taking away the protections needed by the actual asylum seekers. Let me remind you of a quote published by Vox.com, V-O-X, not Fox, Vox, V-O-X. They had a statement from one of these illegal immigrants saying, "We just want Buffalo Wild Wings." I'm not trying to be a dick. I'm trying to show you the severity of the difference. When someone says, "I want Buffalo Wild Wings," and someone else says, "The gangs and the cartels are trying to kill me," I think there's an obvious thing we can do here and protect those whose lives are in danger and tell the person, I get it, you want chicken wings, but guess what? Buffalo Wild Wings is all over Mexico too. Like, dude, you're not entitled to any of these things. I absolutely believe we should bring all of these people in the legal way for a very simple reason. We need to make sure we can distribute new families in the right ways to help grow the economy, not strain the economy, and not have undocumented people who are at risk, who are sick, and are unvaccinated. Okay? There's a reason why we have a legal process for this. It's very complicated. And no, it is not about dehumanizing or anything. It is about protecting the migrants themselves. Listen, there are kids who are dying. Okay? This is why we need to have a legal standard so they can come in and be safe. So they're not wandering through the desert trying to get, and I'm not being facetious, Buffalo Wild Wings. Okay? That was actually published. VOX, the left wing site, acknowledged this and said many of these people just want better economic circumstances. Mexico is not really that bad. From American standards, Americans have this really negative view of Mexico. Trust me when I say it's not bad. Tijuana's beautiful. They're having problems now because there's too many people there. Mexico City is amazing. The weather is beautiful. The food is great. It's not poor. So if somebody is granted asylum by Mexico or welcomed to the country and offered jobs, that's not a bad situation. We shouldn't ignore that Mexico, you know, would do nothing. But I'll tell you what, Mexico's not going to do more. It's a big thing going out with Trump and the tariffs. But I just want to stress, what really frustrates me here is there are simple truths. Asylum seekers need to be protected. We shouldn't discriminate against migrants, but we do need a legal process to protect the economy and the migrants themselves. It is a system put in place with checks to make sure everyone's okay. Detention centers are having like a mumps outbreak or something like that. I can't remember exactly, mumps or measles. And this is part of the problem, okay? We're already seeing, you know, diseases that we in the United States have wiped out coming back because people aren't vaccinating. These undocumented immigrants are not vaccinated. It's another reason why we have a legal process. By all means, you can come here. It's hard sometimes. There are certain restrictions, but we will do it to keep everyone safe, okay? We want to keep Americans safe. We want to keep the migrants safe. But yes, I think even Trump said, bring all of the migrants in legally. I don't understand why that's a problem to anybody. You know what really bothered me? So let me read a little bit more. May marked the third month in a row that more than 100,000 immigrants were taken into custody at the border amid a surge of migrants heading north in large groups from the Northern Triangle countries of Guatemala, Honduras, and El Salvador. They are draining themselves of their own countries. This can't work. More than 19,000 immigrants are currently in CBP custody. Nearly 1,000 Border Patrol officers have been moved from northern ports of entry, airports, seaports, and elsewhere along the southwest border. We are in a full-blown emergency, and I cannot say the stronger the system is broken. Do you know what the Washington Post said in response to this? And this is why I'm really angry about the story. Because the Washington Post, one day before NBC published this, tariffs won't solve our border crisis, but Democrats denied Trump the tools he needs. When the New York Times comes out, and they did, and they say, Congress, give Trump his money. When the Washington Post says, a day before CBP is saying this is a full-blown emergency, Democrats have denied Trump the tools he needs. I feel like I'm living in some kind of fantasy land where the Democrats just literally don't care. They don't care. Absolutely do not. This is a problem. 144,000 who came in illegally. The story at NBC goes on to say, of the 132,000 who were caught entering the country illegally, more than 84,000 were traveling as a family unit, 36,000 were single adults, and 11,000 were unaccompanied children. This is more than a full-blown emergency, okay? Because I take great issue with this number right here. Why are 11,000 unaccompanied children coming through this country illegally, crossing through the desert, getting sick, etc.? We keep hearing stories about people who are dying in CBP custody, and the left blames CBP. It's a crisis. I'm not going to put the blame on anybody. People came to the desert, got dehydrated and sick, and they died. We need to make sure we don't encourage this behavior and tell them, look, America is for immigrants. It's a country of immigrants, and you are welcome here through a legal process. I have friends in foreign countries that I want to come to the United States. It's very, very difficult. One of my friends is from a rather impoverished nation, and I am doing everything legally to figure out what we can do to get them legally to the United States. Not easy. But there's a reason we do this. It's very important. We can't just bring random people from who knows where. People are vetted. There are threats. And I'm not talking about these illegal immigrants being bad people. I'm sure they're good people who just are desperately trying to improve their situation, and they believe this is the path forward. But the risks are high. And there are children now who are getting sick and hurt. And the Washington Post will rub it in my face that the Democrats are the ones denying the tools he needs while CBP is saying this is an emergency, please. So what do you think someone like me is supposed to do? Okay, let me break this down for you. I think Trump lacks charisma. I think he speaks to a certain group of people. I think he's boorish. I think his tweets can be hard to interpret sometimes, and it's bad in terms of trying to unite the country. There's a lot of things I can criticize him for in terms of his demeanor, and these things put me in a position where I'm predisposed to not liking him, and that's how you can imagine a lot of the other liberals feel. They're like, when Trump says these things, it like gives you the heat, like, come on, man, don't say, you know, but then you have the foreign policy stuff, which I object to on a moral level. Here's the thing, though. I am not led by emotions. It doesn't matter if I like the president or not. There are a lot of Trump supporters who personally don't like his attitude either. I've talked to them about this, and they say it doesn't matter if what he's doing is working. And I say, you know what? I can't argue with that. Well, I can definitely argue with the foreign policy stuff, because define working in that capacity. I have no idea what you mean when you bomb 18-year-old men and call them militants because they're of age, which is what Obama was doing, or when commando raids go in Yemen and kill kids, or when you provide weapons to Saudi Arabia to go and bomb Yemen. Yeah, it's something we shouldn't be involved in. It's a complicated situation. Don't get me wrong. But I can object to that, And it's a very complicated situation. But when we have an absolute border crisis with record numbers, the highest in the past 13 years for any single month, 3 months in a row of record breaking, 11,000 kids coming through the border with no parents, and all the other problems, and I'll stress, unvaccinated, and the Democrats deny the tools, why? The New York Times, okay? The New York Times, the left of center, New York Times, published an editorial board statement saying, Congress, give Trump his money. I am not in some weird, you know, fringe group of liberals who are like, maybe Trump should protect the border. The New York Times is not fringe, okay? They're the urban elites of the left. And they said it's time. And even the Washington Post and other news outlets have said straight up, the Democrats need to do something. What do I hear all day? What are they doing? What is this? Here's a story from the Fox News. Pelosi needs to address invasion at border. Congress inaction shameful, says the GOP. There was another story I wanted to bring up. I guess I don't have it, but it was like I Google searched the Democrats. I was like, what, you know, like Democrat news, and you know, I get a Mueller report, obstruction, impeachment. I'm like, I don't care about any of that. This is crazy to me. You know, it's absolutely, I feel like I can certainly relate to a lot of these people who did support Trump in that we are living in some kind of nonsense, absurd breakdown of social cohesion where the Democrats are just absolutely ignoring this and acting like nothing's happening. That you've got a lot of people calling it a manufactured crisis. And it's like, whatever you want to criticize the president for, I get, you know, grab him by the, you know, statement. The crass and crude things he said. He once played up a Republican who body slammed a journalist and laughed about it. I'm not a fan of those things. I'm not a fan of his attitude, his behavior, and his foreign policy. Can't argue with the booming economy. I don't know enough about it. All I know, it's working. I'm not going to argue with that middle class family in the middle of the country got their jobs back. I can respect and understand that. There's a predisposition among liberals because of Trump's behavior. But you know what? I can put that aside and say, what's going on at the border? Why is this in the news? And why are the Democrats obstructing it? It's not my opinion. The Washington Post has just published this a day before we see this crisis reaching ahead, where CBP is like, it's a full-blown emergency. And if you can't rally behind someone, okay, if the Democrats are unwilling to do this, and then you complain about we shouldn't be caging children. That's what they keep saying. Trump is caging children. Listen. It's not a one-sided problem. It's not all or nothing. It's 11,000 unaccompanied children wandering through the desert. They're by themselves. We need funding to deal with this, and we need to disincentivize this. But instead of talking about the fact the problem exists, they're worried about what Trump does in response to the kids wandering in the desert? Caging children. You mean the unaccompanied kids wandering through the desert who were picked up by CBP, given food and water, and brought to a detention center? I'm not a fan of the detention centers. I'm not a fan of how they're being run. But what's the alternative? What are you literally telling me? The kids should just be left to wander in the desert? We're not going to put the kids in the jails with their parents. I don't know what the solution is, but certainly complaining about it isn't actually solving the problem. Perhaps Congress, like the New York Times said, should give Trump the money he's asking for. I am not someone who arbitrarily has, I don't have arbitrary opinions. I don't just decide I'm going to be on this tribe or this tribe. I sit back and I think about it and say, man, it's a complicated problem. Let's try and break this down. And it takes a long time to really figure these things out. And it got to a point when I saw major publications saying straight up, you know what, Trump's right on this one. And I said, damn, the discussion's over. Like the New York Times, Wall Street Journal, Washington Post are all saying straight up, you know, let's look at this. The Washington Post writes, President Trump is understandably frustrated by the crisis at the border. It's a crisis and Trump's understandably frustrated. I don't know who the Democrats think they're playing to. They are on Twitter reading garbage and their brains are being melted by the ridiculous Twitterati who's like, just open the borders. The Democrats themselves need to pay attention to what's actually happening in this country. Because when you have the Washington Post of all outlets saying that Trump is understandably frustrated by the crisis, so we know it's not a manufactured crisis, and we know, and the Washington Post writer, is this an opinion or it is an opinion, so I can respect that. It's not necessarily the opinion of the Washington Post, but this is not fringe, okay? This is regular Americans. Andrew Yang, bless his heart, tweeted out, like the other day, identity politics is a great way to lose elections. And naturally, a ton of these Twitterati leftists got really mad. Yang held his ground. I have tremendous respect for him. He's right. He said we need to bring people together. He's right. But these Democrats who are playing these games, who are calling this a manufactured crisis, who are ignoring us and obstructing Trump. Look at this. They break down all of the ways the Democrats are blocking Trump from getting the tools he needs to actually solve this problem. While CBP is begging, it's an emergency, record numbers, children. Unaccompanied children. Okay, I'll tell you what. Let me frame this in a way that maybe that some Democrats and liberals can understand. Let me just say this. Trump asked for money for border security, not necessarily the wall, whatever he's asking for. If there are 11,000 unaccompanied children coming through, wandering through the desert, do you think we should probably pay some people to go and take them out of the desert and bring them somewhere to get food and water and keep them safe from sickness and things like this? Or do you think it's better that we don't fund, you know, a division of people to go and take these children to facilities? Do you think it's better that the children are wandering the desert by themselves? Or do you think it's better that they're, you know, sleeping under Mylar blankets in large facilities in, you know, surrounded by chain link fences? That's how I can frame it. Let's put it this way. What would you rather have? A large, you know, 100-foot by 100-foot chain link cage. I'll call it a cage. Full of children sleeping in Mylar blankets, being provided food and water. Some of them are sick, unfortunately. Or would you rather have those kids wandering through the desert by themselves? I don't know what the right answer is. I really don't. All I know is that maybe we should disincentivize this behavior. You know what, man? I rant on this stuff all the time. So I'm just going to end it here. It's, you get it. You know, the Democrats aren't doing anything, and I just get so angered by this. And I think this is one of the things, immigration is a big issue for Americans, and I think this is one of the things that's going to push a lot of moderates to the conservative side, and a lot of independents who lean left will probably still vote, you know, Republican, because they're like, dude, you don't have to agree with Trump on building the wall to recognize 11,000 unaccompanied children coming through this border, wandering through the desert, is a really, really bad thing. One child, to me, is too much. One kid by themselves is too much. But they are human traffickers, okay? We know this is happening. And for whatever goddamn reason, the Democrats are just denying Trump the tools he needs. Whatever, man. More segments to come later today. I can't say I'm shocked by this anymore, you know? Next segment will come up at 1 p.m. On this channel, and I will see you all in the next story.